Hi, this is Sam from CompuPal, and for this video we're going to be learning how to use Netflix on a web browser. So let's get started. We're going to go down here to Internet Explorer, click on that, go up to our search box, type in netflix.com, and hit enter. This will take us to the Netflix home screen. Here you'll see the option to start a free month, which you will have to do to continue the video. Simply enter an email address and password and some credit card information, and you'll be ready to go. Once you have that done, you'll have a membership, and you'll be able to go to the member sign-in. So we'll click on that. Enter your email address associated with that account. Mine is compupal@hotmail.com. And enter the password that you have associated with your Netflix account. Underneath that, you'll see a box that is checked that says, "Remember me on this computer." That's a nice feature Netflix has, so whenever you close out of your web browser and want to watch Netflix again, you don't have to sign in. It'll just take you directly to your Netflix home screen. So once we have everything entered, we're going to hit continue. It's going to check our email and password to make sure there's actually an account associated with those things, and if there is, it's going to take you to your Netflix homepage. So we'll let that load. Okay, here is my Netflix homepage. See my name up there? I'm going to scroll down, and we'll notice a bunch of different TV shows and movies separating the categories, the top one being popular on Netflix. These are TV shows and movies that other Netflix users have liked and watch often. On the left and right, you'll see arrows that let you kind of scroll through the category. You can go forward and back. And whenever we hover over movies and TV shows, we'll see a red arrow appear. This is the play button. Just click on the title and it will play it for you. If we continue to hover over a title, it'll bring up a pop-up window. It tells you what the show's called, how many seasons it has, a little bit of information about it. And on the bottom, it will give you a rating system. Anything that has red stars is what Netflix will think you will think of it. It normally does this before you've rated something yourself. So at any point in time, we can click on a title, and we can rate it 1 to 5 stars, depending on how much we like it. So let's continue down. Whenever we rate things, it's going to take them, and it's going to make a section called Top Picks for You, which I've only rated about 4 or 5 things, so it doesn't exactly know what I like, but some of it's pretty close. I did rate Breaking Bad. You'll notice that the stars are yellow now, so that appears on my top picks. We continue to scroll down. A lot of different categories of things for us to watch. Eventually you'll get a section like this. Rate what you've seen to discover suggestions for you. It'll give you 4 random movies and TV shows. What you do is you can just rate them, or if you've never seen them before, you can hit the X, or I haven't seen it, and it will pick 2 new movies or TV shows for you to rate. You can do this with as many titles as you want to kind of tailor Netflix perfectly to what you like. So let's say we want to find something specific, and we know that there's a lot of different categories and a lot of different TV shows and movies for us to watch, and we don't want to look through it all to find it. Netflix has its own search box up here for us to just enter the title and it will find it for us. You can either enter the title, or who stars in it, or who directed it, and Netflix will do its best to find it for you. So let's say, since I really like Breaking Bad, let's look for it. As we type, you'll notice that Netflix tries to guess what you're typing. We're going to go ahead and click on Breaking Bad. It'll bring it up for us. I want to watch it, but I don't want to watch it right now, so what we're going to do is we're going to add it to the instant queue. You're going to go ahead and click on this. It'll bring up this window suggesting other things that are like Breaking Bad that you might want to watch now or later. But right now we're just going to worry about this. We're going to close that. Now, whenever we go up to our instant queue, we just click on it, and our shows are there for us to watch. This way we don't have to search for them anymore. So we can play them now, we can rate them after we're done, and we can remove them from the list whenever we don't want to watch it anymore. So we'll go ahead and leave that there. Now we go back to our Netflix home screen. Now you'll notice this navigation bar we have on top here under the Watch Instantly. Gives you a bunch of different categories, so if you're not really looking for a specific title, you want to just watch maybe a drama. It'll give you a bunch of different dramas you can watch. You want to search for things that are just shot in HD, maybe foreign films. You just select the category. If you have kids, Netflix has its own kids section. That way you don't have to worry about them watching something they shouldn't be watching. They just pick the category just like an adult would, and it just brings up kid-related shows. Now that's pretty much it for Netflix navigation. Using those steps, you can pretty much find anything that you're looking for. So if you have any other questions about Netflix navigation, just leave a comment below. And thank you for watching.